Hey, it's Clint Garrett, Ace Networker here, and we're about to take a close look at firewalls in this short video, and I'm going to give you a simple firewall tutorial for beginners here in this short series. What they do, why they're needed, so stay tuned. Are you ready? So what are firewalls and why are they needed? To define a network firewall as simply as possible, it is a filter in the form of a physical device or software that protects an internal network from unauthorized access. It filters the traffic coming into and exiting your internal network to prevent malicious attacks and programs on the internet or the external network that it's connected to from affecting your internal network. Now, with that being said, how does it do that exactly? Well, if we look at the most basic functionality of a firewall, it looks at each packet and makes a decision to block or allow that traffic based on a set of rules. Again, that can be traffic arriving on your network or coming into your network from outside, or inside traffic inside your network traveling outside your network to the external network, which is, again, usually the internet. Okay, so we basically know what a firewall is and what it does now, but there are different types of firewalls and uses for them that you'll need to know to pass the Network Plus exam or the CCNA. When you see the actual hardware component or appliance firewall, a device that is built as a firewall, in other words, that's why it was built, it is known as a network-based firewall. Typically, you will see a network-based firewall placed between your internal LAN, your local area network, and the external network, again, usually the internet. If you use or operate a network-based hardware firewall, it is usually used as the first line of defense on your internal network. Network-based firewalls really tend to serve this purpose well to protect your network from external attacks and malicious intent. However, they are of little use to any attacks coming from inside your local area network. This is where host-based or software firewalls are used. Host-based software firewalls are installed on a host to provide firewall services for just that machine. A good example of a host-based software firewall is the Windows firewall found and used on Windows operating systems. The most often encountered firewall a network admin or technician will deal with is the host-based software firewall. You will also see firewalls that are known as stateful firewalls. Stateful firewalls operate at layer 7 of the OSI model, and they are application or context aware. A stateful firewall uses what's known as deep packet inspection, DPI, to filter the traffic based on the service or the application where the traffic originated. A good example of where deep packet inspection comes in handy is on something like BitTorrent that used to be used that could overload your network because it used port hopping. A stateful firewall using deep packet inspection is invaluable in that type of scenario. And last but certainly not least, you will see what are called stateful inspection firewalls. This is typically on the newer, latest firewalls that you see out there. A stateful inspection firewall is capable of being able to tell if a packet is part of an existing connection. In other words, the firewall can look at a packet and know what that packet's state is in relation to other packets. Now, I'll get into more detail on things like windowing used on session management across a connection when it comes to session layer and the transport layer in the OSI model. But for now, just know that a stateful inspection firewall can tell and be aware of these multiple packets in a connection session. This contrasts to the older stateless inspection firewalls that looked at a packet and they could care less what that packet's relation was to any other packets. So those are the basics of the different types of firewalls you'll encounter and possible use on a computer network. Now, as we get into more detail in our study of computer networking, you'll see how a firewall is only part of an overall toolkit for providing security on a computer network. When we get into network security, we'll talk more about how firewalls are but one tool in what they call UTM, Unified Threat Management. Unified Threat Management encompasses not only firewalls, but other security services such as VPN, IPS, load balancing, antivirus, and several other features, all depending on the applications and devices being used, as well as the makes and models. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.